Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fine and staying home to keep yourself safe from COVID-19. Students, in the previous module, we discussed about the Union Legislature and Lok Sabha. So here in this module, we are going to discuss about the Rajya Sabha and the different powers given to the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. You can say power given to the Parliament, powers of Parliament. So the Rajya Sabha, the maximum strength of Rajya Sabha is 250. Out of these, 12 members are nominated by the President of India and remaining 238 are elected from the state and union territories by the elected members of the state legislative assemblies. That state legislative assembly is that assembly which is responsible for making the Chief Minister of the different states. Just like Lok Sabha is there in the center, similarly there is Vidhan Sabha in the different states. So that is a state legislative assembly. The 12 nominated members are distinguished personalities who excel in various fields of art, literature, science, social service, sports, etc. It doesn't mean that the members are excelling in all these fields, but they may excel in any of these fields or maybe more than one field out of these. And these are some example only. So that members are nominated from these categories. Now qualification. To become a member of Rajya Sabha, a person must be citizen of India and not less than 30 years of age. You know, student, that for being member of Lok Sabha, there is a minimum is 25 year old. But here, 30 years of age is the minimum age. Her or his name must be in the voters list. Now, the election and tenure. Unlike the Lok Sabha, the Rajya Sabha is a permanent house which can never be dissolved. Means, just like the Lok Sabha tenure, that after every 5 years, that Lok Sabha is dismissed, or you can say, then afterward, re-elections are held. After means in the Rajya Sabha here, after every 2 years, 1/3 of its members retire and elections are held to fill these seats. So as 1/3 of members are retiring after every 2 years, and that way the enough members are existing forever in the Rajya Sabha. So that is why it is permanent house. Therefore, the each member of Rajya Sabha has a term of 6 years. So here, in this Rajya Sabha, tenure of one member is there of 6 years. The Vice President of India is the ex officio chairman of Rajya Sabha. Just like a speaker in the Lok Sabha, here officio, ex officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha is Vice President of India, and present Vice President of India is Mr. Venkaiya Naidu. Like the Lok Sabha Speaker, she or he also presides over the meetings of Rajya Sabha, conducts its proceedings and maintains the discipline and decorum of the House. Since the Vice President is not a member of the House, she or he cannot vote on any issue, whereas the Lok Sabha Speaker can vote. So Vice President is not participating in the voting, but Lok Sabha Speaker participate in the voting. The Rajya Sabha elects its deputy chairman also from amongst its member who perform the duties of chairman in her or his absence. So whenever vice president is absent, so the deputy chairman is taking the charge of speaker in Rajya Sabha. Now powers and functions of Union Parliament. So legislative power. The parliament is the highest law-making body. It makes laws on all subjects enlisted in the union list, the concurrent list, and the residuary subjects. Under the special circumstances, it can also make laws on the subjects given in the state list also. The making of a law is initiated by introducing a legislative proposal for the bill other than the money bill in either of two houses of parliament. Means whenever any law is being initiated or going to be passed, first of all it is introduced in any of the houses, and then afterward discussions are held and voting is done, and then afterward the approval of both the houses is necessary for passing a bill. In case of a disagreement between the two houses applicable to ordinary bill only, a majority vote is taken in the joint meeting of both the houses. If agreement is not looking that general majority is not looking, then afterward there is a voting done for that kind of issues, for that kind of bills, and then it is passed if majority votes are going in the favor of the bill. There is no provision to hold a joint meeting in case of money bills or amendments bills. So after a bill is approved by both the houses, it is sent to president for her or his consent. Means after passing bill in the parliament, that bill is sent to the president of India, and then if it is signed by the president, then that becomes a law. Once consent is provided, means president is signing that bill, the bill becomes a law. Control over the executives. In the parliamentary form of democracy, the Council of Ministers is collectively responsible for the Lok Sabha, to the Lok Sabha. Here collective responsibility is there. It means not a single person will be responsible for any kind of fault done in the parliament or the decision taken by the parliament. We cannot say that a single person is responsible for the decision. The whole parliament is jointly responsible for passing any kind of bill. So that way there is a collective responsibility of the Lok Sabha. In case a vote of non-confidence is passed against any one minister, the whole Council of Ministers has to resign collectively. If non-confidence is passed, means if the people are able to prove, the members are able to prove that they are not the ruling party, you can say, the member is not having majority of votes, then the whole Council of Ministers will be resigning from the post for the parliament. The parliament has also controls the executive by asking questions. So the members in the parliament, whether they are in opposition, even though they are in opposition, their responsibility is to control the different proceedings and the bills introduced by the ruling party by asking questions, by doing arguments. The period when questions are asked, that is called the question hour. Since Rajya Sabha cannot pass a vote of non-confidence, Lok Sabha has more effective control over the union executives whenever this non-confidence voting is done. So that time Rajya Sabha is not participating in that voting. So that is why Lok Sabha is getting more power over the union executive, over the government. Financial powers. The annual budget of the central government is passed by the parliament every year. The government cannot impose any tax or incur any expenditure if the proposal are not approved by the parliament. So, if the parliament is not approving, it means the members, whether they are in the ruling party or in the opposition, if they are not giving 2/3 majority to the bill or to the tax or any kind of change, that cannot be imposed by the government. So regarding money matters, Lok Sabha is much more powerful than Rajya Sabha. The money bill can only be introduced in Lok Sabha. So whenever money bill is introduced, that is introduced in the Lok Sabha. If Rajya Sabha makes any recommendation regarding a money bill, Lok Sabha may or may not accept it. In the money bill, Lok Sabha has more power, and it is up to the Lok Sabha whether it is accepting the recommendation of Rajya Sabha or not. Now, power to amend the constitution. Regarding the amendments of constitution, both the houses enjoy equal power. An amendment bill can be introduced in either house, but it must be passed by each house separately. The Constitution of India provides three methods of amending the Constitution, about which you have studied in the previous chapter, that is chapter 16, our Constitution. The judicial powers. The parliament is empowered to remove the president, the judges of Supreme Court and the High Court, but it is not a simple procedure, not a very easy task. The procedure adopted for this purpose is called impeachment. So for this, a resolution has to be passed by both the houses of the parliament by a special majority, that is absolute majority of the total membership and 2/3 majority of the members present and voting in each house during the same session. So such way that resolution has to be passed if the parliament is going to remove either any of these president, judges of Supreme Court and High Court. Now, the electoral functions. The members of parliament exercise their right to vote to elect president and the vice president of India. So, this is electoral functions of the members of parliament. So, this was all about in this chapter, students. We'll meet in next module with some other topics of different chapter. Till then, bye all of you. Thank you. Have a nice day. Enjoy your day.